Herd immunity. It's kind of a funny phrase. What is it? How does it work? And why do we care? A contagious disease spreads when one person gets exposed, becomes infected, and then passes that infection on to someone else. Some pathogens, like HIV, only spread when body fluids are exchanged. SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, spreads generally through the air and also on surfaces, similar to the ways you can catch a cold. When everyone in a population is susceptible, a disease can spread from person to person easily. This is what we call a naive population. Susceptibility means that a person who is exposed to something is able to become infected with it. This is different from vulnerability, which means that a person is more likely to be exposed in the first place, for instance, because they live or work in close contact with infected people. People can be more susceptible to an illness for all kinds of reasons. Older people are more susceptible to COVID-19. So are people with certain other health conditions, including diabetes. Young, healthy people can still get COVID and even get really sick. It's just less likely. Someone who's immune to an illness is not susceptible to infection. When an infected person comes into contact with a person who is immune, the chain of transmission breaks. That protects the immune person, but it also protects everyone the immune person comes into contact with. The idea behind herd immunity is that if there are enough people in a population who are immune, a virus can't get a foothold. Small, local outbreaks might still happen, but they won't spread further. The whole population, the herd, is protected by those who are immune. Herd immunity is one of the main ideas behind widespread vaccination campaigns. Not everyone can get vaccinated, including the very young, people who are allergic to vaccine ingredients, or people with immune systems that have been weakened by conditions like AIDS or certain medications, including chemotherapy and anti-rejection drugs. But those people can still be protected from disease if there are enough vaccinated people in the population to keep the virus from getting to them. The proportion of people who need to be immune to a virus to stop it from spreading, what we call the herd immunity threshold, depends on how easy it is for the virus to spread. This threshold is more a theoretical estimate than a precise target because it's based on factors that change from population to population. But it gives us an idea of how many people need to be immune to protect others. If a virus is hard to spread, you might only need 30 or 40% of the population to be immune to reach herd immunity. If it's highly infectious, like measles, you might need more like 95%. We're not sure what the herd immunity threshold is for SARS-CoV-2, but most estimates range between 40 and 75%, although some are as high as 83%. Theoretically, herd immunity could develop through natural infections. If a disease spreads widely in a population, and people who recover are immune and stay immune, maybe enough people could become immune to keep the virus from getting a foothold again. The problem with this is that for a disease like COVID that causes really serious complications or even death, a lot of people would get seriously ill or die before we reached that threshold. And it's also not clear that recovering from COVID gives you long-lasting immunity. Right now, it's looking like it gives you about 3 months of protection after you get well. So if you came down with COVID on Halloween, made a full recovery, and developed temporary immunity, you could get sick again by Valentine's Day. Letting COVID spread unchecked would result in massive, widespread, completely preventable suffering and death, even beyond what we've already seen. As of this recording, we've just hit 300,000 deaths in the United States. Giving up on prevention and relying on natural herd immunity would likely double or even triple that number. So, could herd immunity protect us from COVID? Well, if a large number of people become durably immune, then yes, COVID will have a hard time spreading. But we won't get there through natural infection. That would come with a huge human cost, and we're not even sure how well it would work. The only realistic route to herd immunity is widespread vaccination. And just like with illnesses like measles or polio, all of us who can get vaccinated need to do so that our immunity will protect those who can't.